running. Set, go.
Jimmy Kimmel Live. This is ridiculous.
Back at home.
Hi, I'm Jimmy. I'm the host of the show. Thanks for watching. A special shout out to those of you watching from other countries on YouTube, enjoying our comeuppance from afar. Oh, we know you are. And I don't blame you. We had it coming here in the United States, where we are on chapter 11 of Donald Trump's presidency. Somehow he's still president, but with only 9 days left in office, Trump could very well make history, becoming the first U.S. president to get impeached twice. Democrats intend to charge Trump with incitement of insurrection. The plan, according to Speaker Pelosi, is to give Mike Pence one last chance to invoke the 25th Amendment. And if he doesn't, which he won't, they'll move to impeach on Wednesday. Pence has reportedly said privately that he'd consider invoking the 25th if Trump becomes more unstable. That's like Noah saying, if this rain gets any worse, I might have to build an ark. There's bad blood in the West Wing right now. Trump had reportedly still not checked in on Pence, who his mob wanted to hang when they stormed the Capitol on Wednesday. They wanted to hang his vice president, and Trump's like, thank you, we love you. What's for lunch? POTUS and VPOTUS had not spoken since Wednesday. They finally met at the White House today. According to the official report, the two had a good conversation discussing the week ahead and reflecting on the last 4 years of the administration's work and accomplishments. Right? I'm sure that's exactly how it went. Things have gotten so tense between them, Trump has started calling Pence Melania. And Melania is something else, too. This morning, Melania Trump finally issued a statement expressing her sympathy for the real victim of the events last week, Melania Trump. She wrote, I am disappointed and disheartened with what happened last week. I find it shameful that surrounding these tragic events, there has been salacious gossip, unwarranted personal attacks, and false misleading accusations on me from people who are looking to be relevant and have an agenda. I have no idea what salacious gossip she's talking about, but now I'm definitely going to Google it to find out. During the insurrection, Melania was reportedly doing a photo shoot for a coffee table book about furniture in the White House. She kept the shoot going as these nuts were kicking in the doors at the Capitol because she wants her book to be best, that's all. But Melania says this is the time for healing, not division. That's a talking point a lot of these complicit Republicans are spewing now. It's time for healing, and I'm all for healing. But before we heal, we need to make sure the surgery is finished and there's still a large cancerous tumor that needs to be removed. Many have noticed that Melania's statement appeared to copy the wording of an earlier speech she gave at the Republican National Convention in August. This is what she said then. She said, the common thread in all of these challenging situations is the unwavering resolve to help one another. And this was today. The common thread in all of these challenging situations is Americans' unwavering resolve to help one another. So at least now she's only plagiarizing herself. That's progress, right? In Congress, Republicans are doing everything they can to stave off another impeachment vote. They do not want to be on the record for this one. Several of them are saying 9 days isn't enough time to hold impeachment hearings, and they've got a point. You know, usually when the Senate tries to ram something through that quickly, it's a conservative Supreme Court justice. The House will vote to impeach on Wednesday, but the Senate might not have a trial for months, well after Trump is on summer vacation. And some, like Senator Roy Blunt of Missouri, think there's no need to impeach Trump because he'll probably never, ever do anything like this again.
Are Republican leaders going to hold him accountable in any way for it?
Well, I think the country is the right way to hold presidents accountable. The president should be very careful over the next 10 days that his behavior is what you'd expect from the leader of the greatest country in the world. Now, my personal view is that the president touched the hot stove on Wednesday and is unlikely to touch it again.
Right, yeah. Next time he'll stick his head in the microwave, he's unlikely to touch it again. Right, that's how toddlers do it all the time. Personally, I don't think we should impeach the president twice. I think we should impeach him 3 times just to make sure it sticks. And while we're discussing this 25th Amendment, how about we talk about number 14, which is the amendment that says no person shall hold any office if, as a member of Congress, they shall have engaged in insurrection or rebellion against the same, or given aid or comfort to the enemies thereof. Aid or comfort to the enemies thereof. You mean like Josh Hawley, the senator from Missouri, giving the universal aid and comfort sign to the friendly folks who killed a police officer trying to get Nancy Pelosi's Post-its off her desk? Like that? If only someone had warned us how Donald Trump would react to losing an election. If only someone had seen this coming.
He lost the Iowa caucus. He lost the Wisconsin primary. He said the Republican primary was rigged against him. Then Trump University gets sued for fraud and racketeering. He claims the court system and the federal judge is rigged against him. There was even a time when he didn't get an Emmy for his TV program 3 years in a row, and he started tweeting that the Emmys were rigged against
him. Should have gotten it.
This is a mindset. This is how Donald thinks.
She's smart. That lady should run for president. You know what? Maybe we should give him an Emmy. Maybe we need to entice him out of office. You think he'd resign if HBO offered him the part of Samantha in the new Sex and the City? Really, it's worth a try. A lot of his cabinet and staff have resigned, but some of them are standing by their man during this very sensitive time for him emotionally.
With the social media crackdown, does he feel emasculated, especially as he heads out of office?
Look, I wouldn't say emasculated. I mean, if the most masculine person I think to ever hold the White House is the President of the United States.
Right, he's so masculine, sometimes I'm not even able to stand up. I mean, have you seen him dance to YMCA? Where do these guys come from? And why can't I find one of them to work for me? At one point on Friday, Trump is reported to have yelled at everyone, "I am not going to resign." He's planning to spend his last week on the job taking a victory lap to celebrate his imagined accomplishments. He's headed to the border tomorrow to show off some of that wall Mexico never paid for. And in the meantime, his official schedule is robust. President Trump will work from early in the morning until late in the evening. He will make many calls and have many meetings. That's what I say when my kids knock on the bathroom door. I have many calls and many meetings in here. According to the FBI, armed protests are being planned at the capitals of all 50 states from January 16th to Inauguration Day, and the FBI reports that the insane clown posse grabbers may try to storm the U.S. Capitol again, too. We've been getting more details about these storm Trumpers. Some of them have been arrested, and some didn't storm the Capitol alone. A few brought along a plus one, including this guy, infamously pictured in paramilitary gear. He showed up with a bunch of zip ties and his mom. I guess he needed someone to drive him home. My God, I'd be so embarrassed if my mom saw me with an insurrection. Remember the good old days when Norman Bates and his mother never left the motel? But you know what they say, the apple doesn't fall far from the treason. The MAGA Avengers were in full force at Twitter headquarters today on behalf of their dear misleader. It's been unusually quiet over the past few days because Trump has been banned from Twitter permanently. Which I have to say, the only thing scarier than Donald Trump tweeting is Donald Trump not tweeting. It was a way for us to know where he was. It's like when they put a bell on a cow. Trump's account was suspended on Friday, so he tried to tweet from the official POTUS account instead, and then they stopped that too. Many in Trump land believe it's wrong to encourage a corporation to ban someone for their political statements, which, who was the guy who told the NFL to ban the players who kneel? Oh, that was Donald Trump. I guess that was different. Trump has been suspended from Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and even Snapchat. But don't worry, Mr. President, there are still plenty of apps you do have access to. You still have Spotify to drown out the sound of millions of people cheering as you leave. You still have Pet Finder, since you're on the outs with Mike Pence. You have Cameo, which will soon be your primary source of income. You can still play Among Us, a game where everyone accuses each other of being against them. You'd love it. You could play Pokemon Go. You and Donnie Jr. can hunt Pikachus together. And when no one else wants you, don't forget, there's always your old friend, the Domino's Pizza Tracker. Not only did Trump get banned from Twitter, Google, Apple, and Amazon removed the Parler app from their platforms. Parler is where all the right-wingers gather to post QAnon sense and misspell the word parlor. And no one was more upset about Parler going away than a sneaky little congressman named Devin.
But it's more than just the financial aspect to that. Republicans have no way to communicate. I have 3 million followers on Parler. Tonight, I will no longer be able to communicate with those people.
I mean, other than being on Fox News right now. Why does Devin Nunes always look like somebody knocked his ice cream out of his hand? Trumpers are complaining bitterly that they're being silenced. In fact, they won't shut up about being silenced. On their three propaganda TV networks, on 1,000 conservative radio shows, all over the internet, they are screaming about being silenced. They won't be silent about being silenced. And of all the things Donald Trump has to be upset about over the past few days, the impeachment, the 25th Amendment, the Twitter ban, this is the one that is reported to have bothered him the most. The PGA last night decided not to host the 2022 PGA Championship at his golf course in New Jersey, and they have no plans to stage the British Open at his Turnberry course in Scotland. Things have turned very fast on Donald Trump. Trump was said to be gutted by this. You know, usually when Trump loses a golf tournament, it's because chicken nugget grease kept causing the club to slip out of his hands. The president has not spoken publicly about COVID, which is killing more than 3,000 Americans a day since December 9th, more than a month. 3,000 people a day is a lot of people for a fake virus manufactured by the Democrats in China to topple Donald Trump. And this is interesting. Someone on Twitter noticed an unusual trend. There are angry ladies all over Yankee Candle's site reporting that none of the candles they just got had any smell at all. I wonder if they're feeling a little hot and nothing has much taste for the last couple days, too. In other words, maybe the reason they can't smell the candles is because they have COVID and don't know it. So a Harvard psychology research assistant picked up on this and compiled data from Amazon of reviews left in 2020 about scented candles. And here's what she found. Reviews of candles remained virtually unchanged for about 3 years. Then, when the first cases of COVID hit the United States, that's the red line on this chart, they nosedive. By comparison, she compiled the reviews of scented candles versus unscented candles on Amazon this year. The unscented candles is in orange, the scented are in blue. You can see blue took a massive hit. These reviews aren't just bad reviews either. They're snarky and aggressive. This one is called, "What is wrong with this company? I exchanged an unscented Santa's cookies for this highly rated, sold out, yet also highly unscented apple pumpkin facepalm. What in the lack of quality control? Why don't any of these Yankee candles actually have any fragrance? This is ridiculous." Here's another one. "Disappointing this year. The quality of the scent is gone." Or maybe you have the coronavirus. There are lots of reviews like this, and I became curious about what the people at Yankee Candles, the company, think about it. So we got in contact with them, and joining us now is their Vice President of Scent and Fragrance, Kyle Admonson. Hello, Kyle. How are you? Kyle.
Hi. Hello there, Jimmy. I was just adding a few more slices to our banana nut bread mix candle.
Oh, wait a minute. You put real banana bread in those candles?
Heck yes, we do. You should see me trying to put a pumpkin in there for our autumn gathering line. It's very difficult. But you know what they say? Make candles in a blender and you'll never work a day in your life.
Hey, you know, I don't believe I've ever heard anyone say that before ever, but...
Well, that's because you're not a cool guy who makes candles.
Very true. Okay. Hey, I wanted to talk to you about some of these negative reviews you've been getting lately.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. I've noticed...
What a bunch of chuckleheads.
Yeah. Well, watch the language, Kyle. We're on television, but...
But it's just these COVID positive pinheads. I'll be honest with you, they're really starting to pee me off.
I get that, but so you do think there might be a connection between COVID and customers saying your candles have lost their scent?
Well, heck yes, I do. You think I don't know how to make a champaca blossom? I've been using the same gosh darn recipe here at this company. The company has for 51 years. But suddenly these dum-dums wander into a mall in South Dakota without a mask on, and they come out crying to me, "Oh, your candles don't smell as good." Boo f***ing who?
Well, it does seem suspicious. It seems odd, doesn't it?
I mean, look, the reality is, truthfully, we always get a few complaints this time of year, okay? From some of these pickle brains come out and say, "Hey, I've been to the Bahamas, and the breezes don't smell like that." You know, you can't put a breeze in a blender. You just got to do your best. But this year is nuts. Here, listen to this bozo. Listen to this one here. She's going, "Something is wrong with the candles I bought. The balsam and cedar has no scent at all. I used to use them from one Christmas to the next, but this year something is wrong. Oh, really? When did you write this? November 29th? Okay, is that right after Thanksgiving? Did you maybe invite a bunch of your stupid family over to cough all over your turkey? Turkey?
Right. Now, Kyle, I understand that you're angry, but...
Yeah, right, I'm angry. Look, yeah. I didn't spend 6 years at the Beeswax Academy getting a master's in chandlery, that's the art of candle making, so our consumer rating could get all cucked up by these busybodies. They could suck my wick.
Oh, now, Kyle, please relax. You really need to calm down a little. And
You're right. You're right. Yeah. I actually do need to calm down a little bit. Here, I'm gonna enjoy a little bit of...
What's that one?
Angel's Wings. That's my all-time favorite.
That sounds nice. What is in that? What's in Angel's Wings?
Angel dust.
Wait, angel dust like the PCP, the hallucinogenic?
I feel great.
Okay, yeah, I guess that it is, but yeah.
Oh, you! I knew it was you!
You did what? Kyle, you all right?
You! Beelzebub is thy name.
No. My name is Jimmy, but I could, yeah.
Satan, shall snuff thee like a jar of midnight jasmine.
Well, thank you, Kyle. Please be careful with that thing, okay? That's all right. Hey, thanks, Kyle.
Jimmy Kimmel Live. This is ridiculous.